Hi, hello everyone, welcome to the video. And this we are going to discuss about the basic and essential tags in HTML. Hope you have watched my previous video on learn HTML in 10 minutes. If not, please watch that video and come back again. Let's get into the video. So as already told, HTML hypertext markup language is used for web development, and it does not stand alone. You need to learn lot of other steps also. So if you know only HTML alone, you can able to develop only a simple website, that is static website, right? So if you want some client-side programs, if you want to validate something, you have to learn JavaScript. If you want to learn server-side scripting, and if you want to do something in server-side or a database kind of things, you have to learn PHP, Java, and much more related to that. And if you want a dynamic website, you have to learn the AJAX technology, like the part of the website reloads instead of reloading the entire web page again. This reduces the time consumption and memory consumption of a website. And for designing or attractive web pages, you need to learn CSS, right? So all this comprises of to give a wonderful website to you, but still HTML is the basic part of development. As you already discussed earlier, .html is the extension for the HTML file, and you need only the text editor to program HTML pages, and you have this two sections, head and body, inside HTML. So these are all the basic part. Yes, when it comes to HTML, you have to know about the tags and attributes of it. Tags is nothing but the text mentioned in between the angular brackets. Here we have an example of p tag, that is paragraph tag, mentioned inside angular brackets. When you have a slash, that's closing tag. Without the slash, it's opening tag. And to say about the attributes is a name value pass. It can store, or it will give you some more information about the tag. Say here, img is an image tag, which has the two attributes called src and alt, that is source and alternative. Source represents the location of that image file, whereas your alternate tag represents the text instead of that image. The user, when they are hovering the mouse over the image, it will display this text. Okay, so even though if the image is not loaded, the user can able to know what kind of image it is using the text of it. The tags, yes, you can able to give tags inside another tag, but there is a condition, you cannot overlap the tags. Say on the first line, A tag, P tag, and you cannot able to close the first tag, that is the first come first, so it's not like that. We have to close the inner tag first, and you have to close the outer tag later, like given in the second line. Okay, so many of you are wondering about what's the difference between HTML and XHTML. The basic thing is, in HTML there is a format for the HTML file, but no need to follow it, right? But in XHTML, it's not like that. You have to strictly follow all the rules and regulations, and the structure of the data only is defined in that, and remaining all the other parts like formatting, other things will be left out to the CSS or JavaScript. As I told, in XHTML, you have to use the doc type to define what is the type of the document, but it is not necessary in the HTML. You have to write all the letters in the lower case, where even though HTML is not case sensitive, it is supposed to write the letters in lower cases. And you have to mention all the attribute values within the double quotes in XHTML, that is must. And the tag must have an end tag. So with all these rules will be useful for the other guy who is going to take over your code, and if they want to edit something, if they want to overview it, it will be useful for the other guys. Say for example, in production field, like in many of IT industries, if you follow all these rules, it will be easy for future editing purposes. So following all the rules is very strict in XHTML, where it is not in HTML. So this is the main difference between HTML and XHTML. So as we discussed earlier, this is the HTML template, as the HTML tag in it, head section and body section, and within the head section, you have to mention the title, that is the title of the website. Okay, the same thing as explained here, your head section will have the metadata, styling tags, CSS styles, validation, like using the JavaScript code. All those things will comes under head section, and even your body section, whatever the things that is visible in the web page, all those contents will be in your body section. And regarding validation of HTML, there is no compiler for HTML like other programming is having. You have some online validation tools like WC3, HTMLtidy, like that, so you can able to validate all your HTML documents, mainly used for finding whether any closing tag is missed or something like that. You can use these online tools for HTML validations. And from here, we will see all the essential tags that everyone must know when you are going to study HTML. So starting with the heading tags, we have H1 to H6. H1 is the largest tag used for a main heading, and going on H2, H3, the strength of the font will be reducing. So available still H6 used for subheadings, etc. And P tag and division, both are similar, whereas P tag is used for single paragraph, and the division tag, which may contains more than one paragraph, right? So it is used for defining the sections. So if some CSS styles has to be applied to particular sections, you can apply using this division tags. And here are the list tags like unordered list, order list. You might have seen the option like bullets and numbering in the Word documents. Right? So the same thing, if you want to be in your website, you can use this list tags. That is, your unordered list will be useful for bullets, and order list will be used for numbering kind of things, and the li items will be used for listing the items inside that. So we will see in the next slides elaborately with examples, in table functions also we will see. So here is the standard list type. You have to use that order list like 1, 2, 3. So you have to use the order list tag called ol. So within this, you are listing the elements with using the tag called li, right? So you can see the output in the right side, how it looks like. Okay. And as I told you earlier, we can able to nest the tags, right? Here it's an example of our nesting the order list and unordered list. So basically we have two unordered lists, English and French. Okay. And within that, each an English and French, we have a ordered list, 1, 2, 3 in English and 1, 2, 3 in the French. Then definition list, it's again a name value pair used for defining like name and value pairs. You can see the example, right? It has two tags with it. The first tag is called DT, and the second tag is called DD. So that is, the DT stands for data and definition term, and DD stands for definition data. So name and value pairs. You can see the example of output here. And next, very useful table tags, because in HTML we don't have any alignment properties. So if you want to align the contents in your web page, using table is very must. So for creating table, you need to use four tags. One is table tag to create the table. Another one is tr tag. So for each and every row, you have to use one tr tag. So for this example, we are using three rows. So three tr tags are there with the ending tag, you can see. And for creating each and every cell, you have to use td's tag. That is table row, and this td stands for table data. So in first row alone, the letters are bold. So because it's heading, right? So instead of TD, you have to use TH, that is table heading. So very simple. Everything is easily understandable, and you can able to practically work on your own. Next one is link. A website is consist of more than web page, or you can able, whether you want to redirect to some other website, you can use the link. The tag used is anchor tag, that is A tag. You need to have one attribute here, that is hreference, hyperlink reference, where it contains the location of that web page or website, right? You can see the example in the down. Same, this is for linking the external files, right? So no need to mention all the styling inside our HTML file itself. You can create a separate file for your CSS files, and it can be used for all kind of websites. It can be linked using this link tag. So rel is nothing but the attribute that is says the relation type, that is style sheet, and the type it mentioned it is a text file, that is CSS file, and hreference it says the location. If it is in the same folder, just the name.css is enough. If it is in another folder, you have to mention the exact location. And again, image tag, the same img is the tag, src and alt is the attributes. It's in another folder called images, so that folder name is mentioned. After that only the file name is mentioned. Okay, in previous video we have used only the name of the file. Since it is available in the same folder, we have used the name alone, but here it's inside the images folder, so we have mentioned that location exactly here. We are going to see about some special markup language like pre-tag. It's very useful tags. Say for example, here the first two lines, the for loop with print I, okay, how it is in the output, it's in the same line, right? It is not considering the enter, it is not considering the space before the print statement. But whenever the statement, same statement is given inside the pre-tag, you can get the same kind of formatting. The enter after the colon is there, the space between the before the print statement is there. So whatever formatting you are used inside the pre-tag, it is reflected as it is. Whereas in normal text, it is not reflected. Okay. So if you have continuous spaces, the HTML will not take it. It will take it as a single space. So, okay. So you have to use the pre-tag, that is to reflect the same formatting you are used in the source file. Next, EM and strong, that is emphasis and strong tag. It's very similar to our italics and bold tag. Okay, so it, if you want to emphasize some text, it will be made italics, and if you want to highlight some text, you can use the strong tag. You can see the output in the slide. Most widely used is forms. So if you want to get some user data, you can use the forms here. Legend tag is used to for mentioning the form name. Okay, like table, form is a tag used to define the form, and within the field set you are going to define what are all the fields inside the form. That is the legend, it's just simply says the name of the form, and the label, right? Label tag used to mention some display some text in it, and the input tag, it will be used to get some input from the user. The type is text here. So it will get the text input from the user, usually the name. And the next thing is the button. This button tag is used to create a button for the form. So and the onClick attribute is used to call the my function. So it says that whenever the button is clicked, the code inside this my function will be getting executed. And form inputs, basically two inputs are mentioned here, that is text input and password input. So in login pages, if you want to hide your password, we have to mention the type as password instead of the text. Okay, so instead of text, it will show a dot or an asterisk, where usually the login page of many websites will be using. And as you all know that if you want to select any one value, you have to use the radio button. So the type is radio here, and all the other attributes that related to this radio button, that is name, it's used to give some name for this, an ID used for accessing this particular element. Okay, if and the value, okay, if the user is clicking this, what out the text value should be used. So these are all the attributes for this input type. Thing is checkbox, whereas in radio button only one value you can select, whereas in checkbox you can select multiple values, that is more than one values. Just you need to change the type into checkbox. The next thing is button. So how to create a button, we have already seen in the form itself. The tag is used as button, on click attribute is used to call the function to execute the code whenever the button is clicked. So reset is also a kind of button where it is used to clear all the datas given in the forms. For example, if more text, radio button, checkbox or click means if you want to change anything, if you want to clear anything, you have to click the reset button. That it can be created in two ways. You can use the input tag or you can either use the button tag. Select option, it's used to give a drop down box inside your form. So it will have one option already selected, and if you want to change, you have to click that and it will list out all the options. In this case, it will list out three options: black, red and white. And if you select black, the value mentioned inside the value attribute will be processed. This is another way of creating the group selection. So in drop down, you have to select, click the drop down and you have to select, but here it will show all the options and you have to select one from it. Deprecated formatting tags. We have so many deprecated tags where HTML does not supports. Say for example frames, where it is not supported by HTML now. Similarly, font like italics bold we are not using, because most of the things like related to the formattings are moving to CSS. So we have also deprecated tags. You have to know each and every version is moving higher. Some tags are being deprecated. Some new tags will be introduced in the newer versions. So when version moves, we have to keep track that what are the tags coming new, what are the tags are deprecated. So that's all, folks, for this video. Keep supporting and keep watching.